MP4, AVI, MOV, MPEG, WMV, MKV, FLV. Oh, have you ever thought about the number of video file formats there are? Why do we need so many, and which one is better for what purpose? Hey there! Welcome back to the Movavi vlog. Daria here. By the way, do you know that we came up with the name Movavi because it's a combination of two popular video file formats, MOV and AVI. Today we're going to explain what video file formats are and what settings you should use to export your videos to different formats. Keep watching! Let's start by figuring out what a video file format is. A video file format is the structure that stores a video recording in your device's memory. A video format is defined by two things: a file container, where data is stored, and a codec, which is used to code and decode video and audio. Not clear yet? Okay, let me explain it a bit more. The container is the file that you can see on your computer or smartphone. It contains an audio track, a video track, a description, subtitles, and many, many other things. The codec compresses the contents of the container so that it's more easily stored in the device memory and more compact. Filming and watching videos may seem easy for humans, but it's hard work for codecs. During the process of shooting, the original sound and image must be encoded into one file. Then when you open the file and start watching, the codecs are decoding the image and sound to make them viewable. The process of coding and decoding is essential for efficiently using the free space on your devices. Let's say you're packing your bag for vacation. Your bag is the container. Your personal belongings are the contents. In our case, it's video, sound, subtitles, and so on. The way you pack your bag is the codec. So the more careful you pack, the more fits in. So all these things make up the video file format. Formats differ in container capacity and codecs. For example, the popular AVI container can hold a few audio tracks and subtitles. The MKV container can hold even more, all the audio and video tracks you want, plus subtitles and subtitle fonts. There are some more distinguishing features that derive from the container capacity and codecs: the file size, video resolution, the ability to play it online, and so on. But if you ask me which file format is the best one, I can't give you a straightforward answer, because everything depends on the device you want to use to watch the video. These days, H.264 is the most common and widely used codec. It's pretty good at file compression, and at the same time, it ensures the minimum video quality loss. MP4 and MKV are quite popular containers, as is the QuickTime container. Those files have the MOV file name extension. Many SLR and mirrorless cameras, as well as Apple smartphones, film videos in the MOV file format, but Android phones don't support it well enough. However, Video Expert isn't just about choosing an appropriate codec. I can explain this more with the help of Movavi Video Editor. Now you've edited your video and it's time to export it. In the panel on the left side of the window, you can choose what you need: video with sound or an audio with file only. Also, if you don't want to have to manage all the export settings, you can simply choose the device on which you plan to watch the video. But let's take a look at the custom settings. First, you have to decide what container you need. We usually export our vlog episodes as MP4 files. Then, open the advanced settings. Choose the codec in the upper part of the screen. We normally use H.264. H.265 is a newer version of this codec, but it requires a lot of system resources, and not every device can play back a file like this. The next step is the resolution. 1920 by 1080 is perfect for YouTube or watching a video at home. If you want to watch the video on your phone or publish it on Instagram, 1280 by 720 is enough. Also, pay attention to the original clip resolution. For example, if your video was shot in 1280 by 720, saving it as a file of higher resolution makes no sense, because it won't make the image any better. This applies to the 16 by 9 aspect ratio, which is the standard for videos on the internet today. 21 by 9 ratio is more common for cinematography. Don't forget about the aspect ratio of the original video when you're changing the video resolution. If you want to learn more about cinematic and other types of ratio, leave a note in the comments below. You can see all the information about your video right in the program. Choose the clip you want, click the right button, and check the information. You can find the video resolution, frame rate, and bitrate here too. The frame rate, or FPS, frame per second, is the number of frames that can be shown every second in your video. In this case, every second of the video file contains almost 30 images. I recommend you choose 24 or 30 FPS. This rate makes the image look smooth and natural.
24 FPS is the movie standard, 25 for TV and 30 for YouTube. Don't set a higher FPS than the original video.
Whether you can make a spectacular slow-motion movie or not depends on the frame rate. Interested? Leave a comment below and we'll make a special episode on this topic.
Bitrate is one of the most important parameters. It sets the image quality and file size. There are three options available: auto, custom, and VBR. The auto bitrate command sets the parameters according to your format and quality preferences. Custom bitrate lets you see the bitrate yourself. As a result, the bitrate will be consistent throughout the whole video. VBR is a variable bitrate, in which the program sets different bitrates for each part of the video. 10 or 25,000 kilobit per second is a good option for YouTube. A lower bitrate can negatively impact the quality, and a high one can make the video too big while the image is unchanged. We usually use 15,000 kilobit per second. The choice of the bitrate depends on the type of video. If it is a short and dynamic video, go for around 20,000 kilobit per second. If it is a 3-hour long record of a university lecture, 5,000 kilobit per second is enough, because the quality is less important. Setting a higher bitrate than the original file makes no sense. In the audio section, it's better to choose stereo channels. The stereo setting separates left and right channels and makes the sound more lively and balanced. The mono setting merges all tracks into one, so the sound is the same in both channels. The sample rate dictates how detailed the sound will be encoded. 48,000 Hz means the program will encode 48,000 units of sound amplitude for each second. We recommend you set 44 or 48 kHz, which are the most commonly used. Done! Now you can export your video.
Don't try to remember everything right away. I'll leave links to detailed articles on this topic in the description. If you still have questions, leave them in the comments below, and we'll answer them as soon as we can. If the example video has grabbed your attention, click here to watch it. It's our episode on shooting a first-person video. Make sure to wash your hands before eating, always listen to your mom's advice, and subscribe to our channel. And remember, the more likes we get for this episode, the cooler the next episode is going to be. See you next week!